Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can pass array of structure into function in C programming. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube search bar. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Now I am going to implement solution of this problem. So first I have included a header file that is stdio.h. Now I am going to declare a structure whose name is employee. It is having first member, that is id of integer type. Second member is name of character type. And then third member salary of float type. So this way I have declared a structure. Now I am going to declare a function whose name is display. Inside this display function, I am going to pass an argument that will be an array of structure employee type. Its return type is void. So this statement is function declaration. Now I am going to define main function. Inside main function, I have to declare an array of structure. Data type is struct employee and array of structure is E of 10. So this way I have declared an array of structure. Now I am going to read values from user. So for that purpose, I am going to implement this loop. Now inside this loop, I am going to print the message first, enter ID, name and salary of person D employee. And then I plus 1. So this way the message enter person D, ID, name and salary, enter ID, name and salary of person D employee. So this person D will be replaced through I plus 1. So initially I is 0. So it will print enter name, ID, name and salary of first employee, then second, third and so on. So this way first this message will be displayed. Then I have to receive input from user. So for that purpose, I am using this notation scanf %d ampersand eofi.id, then get s eofi.name, and again scanf %f ampersand eofi.salary. So this way this loop will read id, name and salary from user. Now to clean buffer, I am going to call this function, that is fflush stdin. So I am calling this function before scanf and gets so that data can be received properly from the user. Now I am going to call display function and I am passing this array of structure into this function. So this is function calling statement and then I am calling return 0. So this way I have implemented the main function definition. Now I am going to define display function definition. So this block will be known as function definition. Now inside this function definition, I am going to apply a logic. So for that purpose, I am implementing a loop. Now I am going to print information of those employees whose salary is greater than 10,000. So for that purpose, I am applying this logic eofi.salary greater than 10,000. So if this condition is true, then I can print id equals to %d eofi.id, then printf name equals to %s eofi.name and salary equals to %f eofi.salary. So this way information of those employees will be displayed whose salary is greater than 10,000. So I have passed an array of structure into function and then function has processed that array of structure so that we can filter some particular records from that array of structure. Now I am going to execute this code. so that we can check whether it is working properly or not. So it is asking for ID name and salary of first employee. So I am entering ID 1, name A, salary 10,000. Then details of second employee, 2, B, 15,000. Then 3, C, 5,000. Then 4, D, 1,000. Then 5, E, 6,000. Then 6, F, 7,000. Then 7, G, 20,000. 8, H, 25,000. 9, I, 5,000. 10, J, 12,000. So this way I have entered all the information of employees. Now you can see it is showing only those records whose salary is greater than 10,000. So ID 2, 7, 8 and 10 are having salaries greater than 10,000. Rest of the employees are getting salaries less than 10,000. So this way I have passed an array of structure into function so that I can filter particular records from that array of structure. I hope you have understood how I have implemented this code in front of you. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Thank you for watching this video.